You're listening to The Foundation of Wellness, a refreshing take on diet and lifestyle with Jessica Dogert, a registered dietitian nutritionist, and Marisa Moon, a primal health coach. Hey, you guys, what's going on? It's me, Marisa Moon, and I'm here flying solo. You are stuck with me all by myself, and so is our guest, Melissa. Jessica's going to be back next week. Don't worry. And I just wanted to let you know the last few episodes have been awesome. If you've missed them, we covered the basics on CBD, and we also talked about holistic dentistry, which you'll see I was kind of a fanatic weirdo about, and Dr. Teplitsky kind of put me in check there, and I needed that. But we covered all these like hot topics like root canals and silver fillings, so that's a really huge one I'd like for you to check out. And then we also had the primal godfather Mark Sisson himself on the podcast talking about longevity in the context of primal movement, endurance training, and just other lifestyle factors, and especially diet and carbohydrate moderation. Now, we're not slowing down at this point. We have some awesome interviews coming up, and today is no exception. We are diving into a pretty confusing topic, if you ask me. I'm thinking you might agree. It's a very now topic, but you've probably been scratching your head trying to understand infrared light, infrared saunas, red light therapy, everything related to that. And even for Jessica and I, we've seen and experienced several types of saunas and red light therapy devices. We've talked to the experts and the reps at our conferences, and we still get confused. So that's why we wanted to invite Melissa Strahan. She's one of the co-founders of Juve Light Therapy. And she's on the podcast today to help us get acquainted with the power of infrared and light therapy. Hey, Melissa. Hello. Nice to have you.
Yeah, it's great to be here.
Juve is really taking the wellness space by storm, thanks to famous biohacker Ben Greenfield, who I'm sure you know, and even Dr. Sarah Ballantyne, who you're going to hear us quote on the podcast quite regularly because she's so trustworthy as a resource for science. And Sarah Ballantyne also endorses Juve and swears by the positive effects it's had on her fibromyalgia pain. And Juve, spelled J-O-O-V-V, is huge with athletes everywhere, NBA, NFL, the UFC athletes, and more. And I think the biggest reason Juve is gaining immense popularity is because it's totally customizable. I mean, they have tabletop and back-of-the-door models. It's pretty awesome. And Juve uses a special LED coating that I'm not even going to try and talk about. That's what Melissa is here for, but I know Juve gets a lot done in a shorter amount of time, so I can't wait to hear about it. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. So go ahead and tell us the cool story behind why you started Juve, because I know you experienced red light therapy before you started Juve, and that was your inspiration, right?
Yeah, correct. In 2014, I was experiencing some eczema in my armpits, and it was the middle of winter in Minnesota, so we don't get much light then, and I was just craving sunlight. And so I was actually thinking about doing a tanning package at a local tanning salon, but, you know, you always have to weigh, like, is that worth it? Because you've got the, you know, bad wavelengths for the skin, you know, so there's all that stuff you got to weigh. And when I went in, I noticed that they had this new therapy called red light therapy, something I'd never heard of before, and they are actually saying it was really good for your skin, which I was like, really? You know, usually you have to weigh, like, is it worth doing this? So I thought, hey, I've got to give this a try. I had no idea about the science behind the therapy at the time. I just thought, this sounds really relaxing. I want to do this. They were saying that it was good for, you know, anti-aging, and who doesn't want some anti-aging benefits as well? So I signed up for a package, and within 6 weeks, I noticed that my eczema was starting to clear up, and I had been trying everything to get that to clear up because, you know, eczema in the armpits, that then you got deodorant problems and everything. It was just a nightmare. Yeah. So I was a believer at that point, but I still didn't understand how the therapy worked. I just knew it was working. And I signed up for a 3-month package, but the salon was 15 minutes from my house. The treatments were 15 minutes. They were telling me I needed to go at least 5 days a week to, you know, continue to see the benefits. And so that was just becoming a huge drain on my time. I'm a mom of six kids, and to be able to get out the door and do that every day, it was just really getting hard. So I started searching the internet to see if I could find something I could use at home. I thought, you know, it might be expensive, but I'm also paying money here, and over time, I'll make up my investment. So when I got online, all I could find was that there was small handheld devices, or maybe just a square that could treat your face. And I was used to laying in a red light therapy bed. So that wasn't going to cut it for me. And I kind of gave up for a while. And then later that fall, I started looking into coffee enemas, actually, because I'd learned that would be a good liver flush. And I thought, hey, that would be helpful. And this doctor had this whole healing protocol for the gut. And part of what he was saying would be really helpful was red light therapy. And I was like, okay, here's that light therapy again. This must be important if, you know, he's putting that in his healing protocol. So he actually had, designs online of how you could use red heat lamps to try to make something for yourself at home. And I thought, this is perfect. It's what I've been looking for. So I talked my husband into going with me to Lowe's and buying the whole setup. We got like the brooder lamps. We got the bulbs to screw into them. We clipped them to a piece of wood that we somehow mounted cattywampus in our shower. And I thought, this is awesome. I'm going to shut the shower curtain and I'm going to have my own red light booth here. And while it felt really awesome, it wasn't giving me the same benefits that I was getting at the salon. And so I went back and I started researching again, and I noticed that Amazon sold therapeutic red light bulbs. And I thought, okay, maybe I have the wrong bulbs. Maybe that's the problem. So I...
Can I just ask, were you originally using those bulbs that you use when you raise like a snake or baby chicks? Like
yes. Yeah. Okay. And they had that just the red rubber coating over them. So then the light that came off of them was a nice red glow, similar to the bed I was laying in. But like I said, at that point in time, I didn't really know anything about the science. So, you know, I just thought, okay, this is red. That's red. Mm-hmm. You know, isn't it the same? But while it felt really good, like a really nice sauna treatment, I wasn't getting those same skin benefits. And I noticed that the bed I was laying in really had no heat, whereas those heat lamps, I mean, wow, you had to sit a ways back and I'm like dripping from sweat. So it was more like a sauna treatment really than a red light treatment. And then I found, oh, you could buy therapeutic red bulbs. Maybe that's my problem. And at that point in time, I enlisted my husband to help me figure this out because he's an engineer and he's always been more into science that way than I have. Although now after learning about all this, I've actually gotten into science myself now.
Yeah.
It's so interesting, much more interesting than when you're like an eighth grader, you know, and you have to learn it, where I was like, same no, here. I don't want to learn this. But now it's like, wow, this is really cool.
Same here. And we amaze ourselves, right?
So, right.
Cool. So what did Justin say?
So he started looking into what is red light therapy, and he found that in the early 1990s, NASA had actually funded a whole bunch of research on red light therapy for keeping their astronauts more healthy in space, which was really cool. Wow. And what we started learning is it's all about the wavelengths of light, which I think is part of the reason that the heat lamps were not as effective, because it's just a red coating over the bulb making that red glow, whereas with what we use now in our technology, we use LEDs, which you can literally set the LED to the specific wavelength, and you have a lot more controlled treatment. And so red wavelengths in the mid-600 nanometer range and near-infrared wavelengths in the mid-800 nanometer range have an incredible ability to enhance cellular function. And it's really all about the mitochondria and feeding that mitochondria the light, which is basically its nourishment for it. And what we learned is that by stimulating that mitochondria, you are actually giving it the ability to boost ATP production by up to 200%, lowering the body's oxidative stress, which we all know when the oxidative stress goes down, you're going to be in a lot better environment for optimal health, for anti-aging. And that's basically how it works. It's very simple. It's light, you know, feeding your cells and enhancing health.
Yeah, wow. I mean, what I'm thinking right now is that many of our listeners may not even understand why the wavelengths matter. And you explained a little bit about mitochondria and ATP, but we haven't even covered that on the podcast yet. So let's just kind of break it down in a very like easy to grasp kind of style, because the mitochondria matter on basically every level of biochemical reactions in the body. Every function that we have really depends on the health of our mitochondria, but it's in every single cell, right? That's why it's so important. Sometimes people call it the powerhouse of the cell. Yeah. And ATP, which you brought up a couple of times, is really what generates energy in the cell. Is that right?
That's correct, yes.
So you mentioned near infrared and far infrared?
Near infrared and then red light.
Red light. Yes. So those are different.
They are. It's all the same spectrum of light. It's just how much are the wavelengths being bent. So the red at in the mid 600 nanometer range, and then the near infrared in the mid 800 nanometer range.
So those are words I didn't even know were different, honestly. The spectrum and the wavelength. So within one spectrum are all different wavelengths.
That's correct, yeah.
Okay. And you guys are trying to harness particular wavelengths that have been proven to have cellular regenerative or protective abilities.
That's correct. Yep.
Cool. So what was it like for you when you first started using it in your home the right way?
You know, it was really cool. I was really excited. It definitely felt like laying in the bed, but even more powerful. In the bed, I had to lay there for like 15 to 20 minutes, where the Juvelite that we, our first model that came out, you only had to treat for 10 minutes per treatment area. So
wow.
That really helped with time, but it was still not full body. You could get about half your body at once. So my husband, by this time, he's like, okay, you have like this device. You've been wanting it so bad. And I go back to him and I'm like, I'm really sorry to say this, but it's not full body. I need full body.
Yeah.
So we went back to the drawing board again and designed an even larger unit, because people don't have time to stand in front of a light for 40 minutes to an hour a day, which is what I was doing at home, just because, you know, I wanted to continue the experiment to see what, you know, what kind of benefits could I get over time. But I was like, I'm going to need a bigger unit. This is not big enough. So we now have devices in all sizes, like you said. So you can decide, do I want to treat just a small section of my body? Do I want to get my whole body? How fast do I want to get my whole body? And
like, you can build your way up to it. Like, financially, that is what makes Juve so awesome. You can work your way up to having a whole room.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. So for our listeners, Juve makes these panels that are literally modular. You can start with one or two or whatever and just work your way up. You know, over the course of 5 years, you can end up having like part of your bathroom being an entire full body infrared treatment center. And a lot of others that are that big, or the kinds you can walk in and do your whole body, we're talking about thousands and thousands of dollars. And so that makes Juve really unique there. It's the red color, particularly in Juve, that also stands apart from other infrared and sauna treatments that I've seen. And why don't you talk a little bit about why you guys chose the red and how that accelerates or reduces the time you need and accelerates the results?
Okay, sure. So the red is going to be really good for skin, collagen production, anti-aging. That wavelength, it does the same thing as the near infrared wavelength. It just sits more at the surface of the skin. So it's going to be really good for thyroid, for your eyes, for like all over skin, for people that are maybe struggling with hair loss. It's really good to treat your scalp.
Wow.
And it does have anti-inflammatory benefits, more for surface layers of skin. The near infrared penetrates the body a lot deeper. It can penetrate through your skull. Very good for organ health, very good for muscle recovery. And so we chose to combine both of those wavelengths in a product because you're getting the best benefits you can at once. You're getting the deep layers of your body while you're getting the surface layers. And the near infrared doesn't have as much benefit for skin because it's focused on driving deeper into the body. So it'll benefit your skin just a little bit on its way to deeper tissue. But if you also are using the red, which sits at the surface the whole time, you're getting an amazing treatment for your skin as well.
Wow. Yeah, the anti-aging benefits, I'm sure, are great. But for people that struggle with eczema and psoriasis, I mean, that can really be something that interferes with your life and your self-confidence, and it can be very irritating. So I think those skin benefits and the scalp benefits, like you said, maybe stimulating some regeneration there in the hair follicles is a pretty big deal.
Yeah, it's pretty big. And, you know, we can never say exactly how fast someone's going to see results or what kind of results they're going to see, because the body is really cool. It knows how to heal itself. And when we give it all of the tools it needs, it goes to work on it immediately. And sometimes people will say, hey, I bought your light because I want to stop, you know, my hair loss, or I really want to get rid of the wrinkles around my eyes. And that isn't happening yet, but I am noticing that I'm sleeping deeper and things like that. And so healing the body comes from within. It comes from that mitochondria and from the cell, and it heals from the inside out. So I always tell people, you know, the cellular benefits are proven, but I can't guarantee how fast or what your body is going to do with that light first. It knows what it needs, and it might be working on a problem you don't even know exists, and you'll never know because you're being preventative and giving your body what it needs.
Oh my gosh, yeah, you said that really well. I think that's important for everyone to understand, because this isn't targeted therapy. This is on a cellular level, helping your body to function the way it was supposed to function to begin with. Mm-hmm. So it's going to address whatever is just threatening its immediate survival.
Yeah.
And sometimes that's not the thing, the symptom that we're living with that's nagging us the most. It's really something that is going to be much deeper, much closer to a cellular level that you don't even notice, and eventually you start finding homeostasis, you know, that state of balance where your cells are all functioning so optimally.
Yeah, exactly.
So tell us a couple of stories about people in your life that have had experiences with Juve that have really changed the way that they live today.
Yeah, my favorite story is my sister-in-law, Jordan. She, when she was a year and a half old, she fell and had an accident where a glass Christmas bulb shattered her eye. And wow. It was devastating. And they did several surgeries and got it functioning better, but she's never had very good eyesight through that eye. She can see more shadows and just nothing like her other eye. And we know that, like, there's a lot of regeneration properties, you know, with this light, but we had no idea how much so. She's 30 now, and that happened when she was a year and a half old. And after she'd been using the light therapy for, like, about a year to a year and a half, she started noticing that she was regaining peripheral vision in that eye that my brother used to kind of lovingly sneak up on her from the side, you know, and he would surprise her, and she didn't know, like, he was there because she didn't have very good peripheral vision. But all of a sudden, one day, he was sneaking up, and she was like, I know you're there. And then she realized, wait a second, I know you're there. And so it was incredible because that accident happened years and years and years ago, and yet the light was regenerating those cells. So it's incredible. Can I say that would happen to everyone? No, but it's for her body, it knew that, hey, we need to fix that. That isn't right. And it took time, like a year and a half. It wasn't overnight, but it was pretty incredible when she called me and told me that. I was like, oh my gosh, I had no idea that could even happen. So
yeah. It really is. I mean, what do you think kept her using it over and over and over if that wasn't her goal?
Well, I think you really have to believe what the light is doing, knowing that it is stimulating that cellular function. Like, I take a multivitamin every day. I don't always see what that multivitamin is doing, but I know, you know, there's proven benefits to giving those vitamins to myself every day. And I think that's the key when people start using any kind of light therapy, is you need to really believe in that cellular function. You need to believe that it's being enhanced, and that that's part of what your body was made to run on. We were made to run on light. Yeah. And then, like I said, you never know what may happen. But I think it's important to look at that and use the light for that versus I need it to fix this and I really hope it fixes it fast, you know? Yeah. And so when you have that mindset and you just start treating and you're not putting pressure on yourself, you're not stressing yourself over what benefits am I going to see. You're just doing it because you know it's healthy for your body. A lot of people say after they start, they do notice that they sleep deeper, that they it brings them out of that fight or flight and into the homeostasis, like you said. So I think it's important to treat for that reason, and then you just you don't know what will come as a side effect of that.
Yeah, and I'm thinking that, like, instinctively, you know, like, it makes you feel good in a way that you can't exactly put to words. I would compare it to CBD because when you take a high-quality CBD, it makes you feel like you're supposed to feel. Mm-hmm. So sometimes because it doesn't make you feel, like, amazing, like I just had triple shot of espresso, yeah. It just makes you feel normal. Yeah. You don't even realize it.
Exactly.
Now, if you were journaling, for instance, before you got the infrared sauna and then you're journaling throughout it, then you might realize, like, wow, I used to wake up crabby every morning mm-hmm. or I used to toss and turn all night long if you're using a sleep tracker. So there's all of these things that can just kind of like slowly start to become more apparent if you are paying attention to the details. Otherwise, I think instinctively you just keep using it because it feels good.
Yeah. And you know what? You're absolutely right because we have people that buy it and they use it and they love it and then they go on a week's vacation somewhere and they're without their light and then they contact us and say, I need to get one that's smaller so I can take it with me. I had no idea. You know, until I was gone for a week, what I was missing. And so I think you're absolutely right. And people instinctively know what makes them feel good. And they go from there with it. Yeah.
Because it's not easy. Like, we all want to work out more. We know it's good for us. We all want to do all these things that we know are good for us. But we can't just do it because of that.
Yeah.
And I think everyone's obsessing over red light and infrared because it does make you feel immediately good. You just maybe can't put it to words, or it may not be exactly the reason that you bought it, but you know you're going to keep doing it because your day is better because of it.
Exactly. Yep.
And just hearing you talk about these stories, I can just imagine all of the stories that you guys hear constantly. It must be so rewarding for you to have created this. In just the past few years, your brand is exploding, and I may be wrong, but I think the biggest reason your brand is exploding, besides the awesome marketing and powerful affiliates you have on your side, I think is because it's so convenient and customizable. And why don't you talk a little bit about that? Because there has to be a reason you guys keep innovating. I mean,
yeah, you know, we realize nobody is going to do this therapy if it's not, like you said, easy and convenient. And there's a study out there now that says that 90% of Americans will live their life indoors, which is, or I'm sorry, Americans will spend 90% of their life indoors.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
And that's a really sad thing, but it's reality with the world we live in. A lot of people have to get up before the light, you know, before daybreak. They come home, they're busy with kids' sports and things like that. And it's just, and then when they do maybe spend time outdoors on the weekends, they got to lather up with sunscreen because they haven't been outdoors all week long and they don't want to get burned, which is a really smart thing to do. But something that we noticed when we started the light and started digging into the research is that the wavelengths in mid-morning actually prepare your sun or your skin to be in the sun later in the afternoon.
Yeah.
And those are the wavelengths that we use in our light. So by someone being able to treat themselves with the Juve every single day, if they are out more on the weekend, their skin is going to be a little bit more accustomed to the light. It's going to make vitamin D better for them. We know vitamin D deficiency is a huge problem in people. And we wanted to come up with something that we could get light into people's homes. Because when you think about 100 years ago, people worked outside. They were outside all the time. I think they didn't even need to eat as much because the light was energizing their body all day long. And now that's just not possible. So we wanted to make that possible. But we also knew it needed to be very convenient. It needed to be able to be done in a short amount of time where people wouldn't have the time for it. But once you make the time and you see how incredible it is in your daily schedule, you want to keep doing it. And so that was really our thinking on making it convenient. And then about a year ago, we launched our modular system because we listened to our customers and they kept telling us, you know, I love this, but I wish it was bigger, or I wish I didn't have to choose a size right away.
Yeah.
And so we thought, okay, you know, we're going to listen to that feedback. And now you can buy one size device and, you know, 6 months to a year down the road, you can add on to that device, like you said, and you can literally build a full body unit, but you don't have to do it right away because it is expensive. It's not, you know, just $20 for, you know, like some things are.
Yeah.
And so we wanted to make it possible for people to build a unit over time.
Yeah, and you did. It's pretty cool what you guys are doing over there. I like that you brought up the fact that we're indoors all the time because it seems like infrared therapy is a trend, like it's just a fad, but why all of a sudden would we need it? But if you think about it, we are exposed to way more blue light and LEDs from our screens and everything, fluorescent LEDs in our home, all hours of the day, even after the sun goes down. And we're not countering those blue and white rays, which we did a podcast on, by the way, you guys. We did one on blue light. You got to check that out if you don't know what I'm talking about. But this is huge. If you can balance that out with something that is closer to the benefits of sunlight, which it sounds like we're getting from red light, Melissa, you can kind of talk to us about the difference there. But and then on top of it, we're not getting any sunlight. So really, this has just been missing, and that's why it's booming right now. That's why everybody's freaking out about it, because you just know when you start using it, it's like, holy cow, my body has totally needed that. So what's the difference like between all these different types of lights?
Well, and I think you hit on it right away with the blue light. And I think that's why people, when they start using red light therapy, they're like, wow, I've been missing this. This feels really good. And they don't even know why. But in nature, there's never any blue light without red light being mixed with it. There needs to be a balance. And like you said, in our homes, we're getting tons of blue light from our computer screens to the lighting, to our phones, to our tablets. We're just being bombarded with it, and there's no red mixed in. And so by adding red light therapy into your daily schedule, you're kind of bringing that balance back that should have been there. And I think people's brains notice it. It's really anti-inflammatory, where blue light is going to cause more inflammation. Red does the opposite. And sometimes people will just tell me, oh my gosh, I don't even know why, but this bright light feels so good on my eyes, or I just feel like my brain relaxed immediately. And I always tell them, I think it's because your body was lacking that balance. Mm. And, you know, now at night, we actually will flip on one of the lights and, you know, try to counteract the blue light at night, or just run the red only. And my kids, it's funny because they've gotten used to it this way now. And if I just flip on a light, they're like, oh, turn that off. Yeah. And so, but we become accustomed. So people have no idea that that's going on with the blue light. And then there's all this stuff now about people aren't sleeping as good. They're not sleeping as deep, and they have no idea. It's because they're staring at their phone screen or watching something before they go to bed. So just by adding in the red light, wearing a good set of blue light blockers at night, just simple things like that, you can bring the nature's balance back and still live in society.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's huge. I think that we all really need that. And maybe that's one of the main reasons why you keep doing it. You just feel like it puts you at ease, and it makes you feel just immediately more balanced. And everybody says it helps them with sleep, and I don't know exactly how that is. Do you?
I really think it's just the counteracting of the blue and bringing, I mean, if we're in fight or flight, our brain's not going to be able to calm down. It's not going to be able to rest. But if you add that back in, I notice now a lot of times at night I try to catch the sunset just because of being more aware of the circadian rhythm clock and how it all works. I will notice as I'm sitting outside watching the sun go down, I feel my body relax. And it's incredible. And I think the light will give you that kind of a feeling at night. And I think it's just because it's telling your brain it's time to slow down, it's time to relax, it's time to go to bed. And at the same time in the morning, it does the opposite. It energizes you and says, okay, it's time to wake up. Because our bodies are really smart, our brains are really smart. They were made to function with the circadian clock outside, the light cycle outside. And the more that we can bring our bodies back to match that, I think the better sleep will be, the better everything will be, hormone production and everything.
You know, I can't believe still that you have six kids. It just blows my mind. You're like superwoman to me. I hope you never feel less than that because you are incredible just for raising six children. That's amazing. And I would love to hear you talk a little bit about red light and how it's affected your children, or if you let them use it, if it's safe for children, and anything you'd like to talk about regarding that.
Yeah, my oldest is 20, and then my youngest is 5. So it's sometimes hard for me to get my young kids to want to go. They're like, Mom, I don't want to do that, you know. Yeah. But my older ones, they'll hop in front of the light all the time because they feel the benefits. And I think it's totally safe for children. I always tell people, though, there isn't any clinical research done yet on children. So if you have any concerns, it's good to check with their pediatrician and make sure that that is something that's good for them. But my kids, down to my 5-year-old, use it. And especially if she's got a cold or I think her immune system is battling something, I'm like, okay, I don't care if you don't want to stand there, you're going in there. And they're always like, give me something to play with then. It's for kids, it's just time. They don't want to stand there. But you know, I'll throw them in for like 5 or 6 minutes, and especially on days when I feel like they aren't getting very much sun, the sun's not out, and I've noticed a huge benefit for them in that.
Well, you already know because you are kind of in the paleosphere. You are dimming lights when it gets to nighttime. Mm-hmm. You're probably limiting electronics at nighttime for your youngest, and that alone, I'm sure you see a difference in their behavior and their compliance when it's time for bed, and their energy when they wake up in the morning. I think kids are just the most affected by all of this artificial light. So whether or not they're using the Juve, I think just implementing some of those like more paleo lifestyle changes regarding light in your house has probably made a big difference.
Well, and that is true because when they were younger, I didn't know a lot about light. Like I said, in 2014 is when I started learning about a lot of this stuff. So I would be like, okay, we're going to go to bed and I'll let you watch, you know, like a half hour episode of something on your iPad while you're laying in bed. And I shudder now when I think that I did that all the time, but it'd be 10 o'clock at night and they would still be awake. Mm. And now with these changes, if we do watch something at night, they've got little blue light blockers they put on, but they go to bed at 7:30, 8 o'clock and they're out right away.
Wait, can you tell us about that again? Because we talked about blue light blockers in our blue light episode. For everyone else, tell them what you mean by that.
Yeah, so it's basically just a set of glasses you put on that have a red tint. You want to make sure you look into them because some of them will only block, say, 10% of blue light. So you want to find ones that are really legitimately blocking most of the blue light. And, you know, you can find them on Amazon. But I found, like, my daughter has cute little pink ones, so she thinks they're pretty, so she wants to wear them and stuff. Wow. And, yeah, it's a simple thing. It might cost you 30, 40, 50 bucks, depending on, you know, what brand you choose. But it's huge because you're protecting your thyroid health, your hormone function. You're helping your brain calm down. And yet you can still watch your favorite episode of a TV show at night if you want to.
Yeah, that's what we do. And I know for people I coach with kids, that's made a big difference when they get them for their kids because you're busy. You have a lot to do as a mom. And sometimes it does help them just behave when you give them a TV show to watch.
Yeah.
And if you just throw on those red, orange, amber glasses, it's really going to make a big difference in their sleep and their behavior. And so,
yeah. Well, and like I said, now my kids, they're accustomed to it. They've gotten used to it. And now if we flip on, you know, a really bright light, which we even have tried, we don't use LED light bulbs in our house. We have like incandescent ones that have a warmer wavelength to help, but still, if you turn them on, they're like, oh, my eyes, you know, turn that off.
I'm the same way. My husband's not as sensitive, but I am the same way. It's like, oh, my gosh, I feel like I've been living in a dungeon when somebody puts a bright light on. It, like, hurts my eyes. I think that I'm going to benefit a lot from the infrared therapy, so I can't wait to get mine. And I don't know if any of our listeners are wondering, is this for everyone? I mean, it sounds like it's for everyone.
Yeah, it's light, like you'd get outdoors, so we recommend everybody get outdoors. I do think it's good to start very slow at first because there can be some detox that can happen initially, and so depending on your health condition, I think it's good to take it and just do like a minute or two at first to see how your body responds. If you start slow, you really can avoid the detox altogether. And mm-hmm. some people don't have any detoxing at all, but some people do. And I always find you just have a better experience at the beginning if you just take the therapy slow at first.
Okay, so when you're talking about taking it slow, let's imagine somebody's also taking it slow by just buying one panel or just buying the tabletop model that you make. Mm-hmm. Like, should they move it around to different parts of their body every day? Or
yeah, we recommend 10 minutes per treatment area. Generally, you're going to want to treat at a distance of 6 inches or so. So because the body is so connected, I recommend, if possible, trying to treat as much of your body as you can, just because sometimes, say you have acne that you're wanting to clear up, well, we know that that is so much of the time connected to your gut and your gut health, so you'd want to treat your gut as well, and that happens for eczema as well. It comes from an inflammatory response, but where is that inflammation coming from? It might not be the area where the eczema is showing up. That might just be referred inflammation. So as much as you can, we recommend treating as much of your body as possible.
And you could just start with a few minutes a day, work your way up to 10 minutes a day. It might start to become your time. This is your time, instead of maybe you've always wanted to try meditation or mindfulness because you knew it was good for you, but you can't get yourself to do it. Maybe this will help you kind of have that alone time, that quiet time. You're not on your device and you're just relaxing. And some people use it every day, specifically after a workout, right? Because this is really beneficial for preventing injuries and also regenerating tissue after injuries.
Yeah, that's correct. It's really good before a workout as well. Some people have told me that they've replaced their pre-workout supplement or drink with the red light. And I always think that's so cool because it's so natural, you know, compared to some of those other things you might be putting in your body.
Yeah. I mean, I even heard that I heard it from Ben Greenfield, there was consideration to ban infrared therapy for professional athletes because it gave them like an actual advantage, a performance advantage.
Yeah, I haven't heard that, but I'm sure, I mean, I think it probably does. It's probably not fair to the players that aren't using it.
That's incredible, man. Can you even imagine if it really makes that big of a difference that they're considering doing that? Like, blows my mind. I would like to know a little bit more about the difference here between like red light that actually gets hot. Does Juve doesn't get hot at all? Mm-hmm. And then what is the difference between that and a sauna? Are some saunas red light and some not? Like, can you help us understand this?
Yeah. So a sauna is going to be completely different therapy. Red light therapy, its clinical term is photobiomodulation. And, so yeah, it's a completely different therapy than sauna therapy. Sauna therapy uses heat, and it induces heat shock proteins in the body to get a cardiovascular response going, similar to like exercise, running. Like, you know, they'll say, I sat in the sauna for 30 minutes. It's equivalent to me running so far. And it's got great detoxifying benefits for the body too, through sweating and things like that. But its main mechanism of action is going to be inducing those heat shock proteins. Okay. With photobiomodulation, there is no heat. It's actually nourishing and feeding the cell. And we're actually big lovers of sauna therapy as well. And we recommend that someone were to use their Juve after their sauna treatment. Similar to like running, eating, you wouldn't eat while you run. You'd want to eat after. And so I think that that is a misconception that some people have, that the therapies are the same, but they're quite different, but both equally important for the body.
Okay. So is there any heat at all when you're using a Juve system?
There's no heat at all. And one of the great benefits of using LEDs that way is that the wavelengths can penetrate the body deeper. When you're using heat, most of those wavelengths get absorbed more at the surface of the skin as radiant heat, and with an LED, it's going to feel just mildly warm, maybe like just a really nice warmth that's relaxing, but by not using heat, you're allowing the wavelengths to penetrate the body quite a bit deeper and feed that mitochondria.
So do you know, like, when you're using it enough, or how can you possibly use it too much?
You really can't overdo the light. There's no negative side effects. However, our cells can only take in so much light at once. So that's why we recommend 10 minutes per area on the body. You can treat up to 3 times per day, but we recommend waiting 5 or 6 hours in between treatments just to give your cells time to process the light.
And what do you think is like the number one thing that you hear time and time again that this is doing for people that they've experienced?
Well, the first thing we usually hear is just that they feel so much more relaxed. They're sleeping deeper. Then after that, that's been one of the hardest things for us in marketing this is it helps so many different demographics, yeah. So many different things. So how do you like get that all for everybody? So I always just take it back to the mechanism of action. You're, you know, increasing the cellular function. You're helping to restore healthy cellular function in some individuals where there was a problem. You're lowering oxidative stress, lowering inflammation, and then so many great things can happen depending on that individual, what was going on in their life. There's really cool studies coming out now about Alzheimer's, mm-hmm. and cognitive function. We had a really cool story of a mom that reached out and told us that her little boy that has Down syndrome, he's 4 and he couldn't walk. And she said she bought the Juvelite for her because she wanted to help increase her thyroid function and thought, hey, you know, Down syndrome is a mitochondrial disease. Perhaps it might help him. And within a week of using the Juvelite, he walked for the first time, which was incredible. God. I can't say that would happen for everybody, but for that little boy, his body needed that light energy, and it energized enough that he could walk. So it's incredible, and that's why we just tell people we can't say what the light's going to do, but we know it's good for you. Wow. Science has proven it's good for you. So
I just have chills all over. I mean, that is just life-changing. And I think about what the light is doing and how, you know, it sounds too good to be true, but I can't stress enough, it's booming for a reason. Mm-hmm. This is really, we are lucky that at this point science has something that we can do to bring indoors, you know, what we are missing in our modern yeah. lives. And the science does prove it. There's tons of clinical research talking about or proving the results with mm-hmm. infrared therapy. And I have friends who, 2 in particular, who have healed injuries that they have tried everything else, everything, including acupuncture and alternative therapies. And until they did cold red light laser therapy, which I'm sure is very similar to what you're talking about with Juve mm-hmm. here. So it's targeted, like cold, not hot, laser therapy that helps them with their point of injury. One in particular had such bad knees he couldn't even walk anymore. And it's arthritis mostly, but... And then another, and he's in his 70s, so that's huge. And then my other friend had a car accident, and after all the physical therapy and everything, you know, her neck is still really bad. She has herniated discs and bulging discs, and using the red light therapy with the cold laser treatments already has helped her so much. And to me, that was just huge, because I told her about it because of the guy I work with that helped his knees. Now he's walking miles a day and doesn't have any issues.
Which is incredible, yeah.
It really is. And I hear that you're FDA approved. What does that mean for Juve?
Yeah, so we are registered with the FDA. It's really cool. The FDA doesn't feel that red and near-infrared light therapy poses much risk, which is helpful for people. It can just make them feel like, okay, I don't need to be afraid of this light. We aren't a cold laser like you were talking about, but you can get the same benefits as a cold laser without the fear of overheating tissue, which is why a lot of scientific studies are now transitioning to using LEDs instead of the cold lasers.
Cool.
Because you can use it in your home. You know, like I said, there's no worry of overheating tissue. But we are registered with the FDA, which means we had to go through a very stringent manufacturing process. So, like, our LEDs are extremely low flicker. They are medical grade, meant to be used on a human versus a lot of light therapy that's out there that is actually a grow light. And hasn't been through those processes to make sure it's safe for eyes and things like that.
So has there been anything coming out about red light that you want to share that is new in the science, or anything that you guys are really happy to see coming to the forefront of scientific proof?
Well, I'm not sure how new this study is, but it was really cool when I read it recently that they're now considering red and near-infrared light therapy to actually act as an antifungal in the gut, which I know that a lot of people struggle with candida, with issues like that, and with the benefits of bringing inflammation down in the gut, as well as just helping to combat that the candida, and also helping if you are, say, on a cleanse or something like for that, it actually helps the pills you're taking work even better. Mm-hmm. I thought that was really cool because a few years back, and that was part of the reason I had the eczema and everything, I was suffering from a gut imbalance, and the light has really helped with that. And it's just cool because that can be a really hard thing for people to overcome sometimes.
I forgot to ask, how's your eczema now?
It's gone. It hasn't ever come back. So
that's so crazy.
Yeah.
Oh my
God. It's incredible.
Even my own mom deals with eczema and psoriasis. And since cleaning up her diet, it's been very tolerable and minimal. Mm-hmm. But I know she would love for it to disappear. It flares up whenever she gets really stressed. So you don't even have flare-ups when you're stressed?
No, I don't.
Oh my God. That's amazing.
It's just gone. And, you know, like, I can't say that that would be the case for everyone, but it's helped me. Another thing that I do with my kids and our whole family has gotten into the practice of is getting outside and grounding every day, just getting our bare feet on the ground. There's a wealth of antioxidants that our bodies can absorb just from, you know, skin contact with the ground. And I really think that that has been huge as well. It works really well with light therapy. We actually recommend that if someone's using the light and feeling like, I want results to happen quicker, we recommend, hey, get grounding into your life, whatever amount you can every day, because it makes a huge difference in bringing inflammation down as well. And it's part of the piece of the puzzle of health. People were outside hundreds of years ago. They weren't wearing rubber-soled shoes. There wasn't cement around everywhere. So I don't think the light is just the only piece of the puzzle, but it's one of the pieces of the puzzle.
Oh, absolutely. I'm sure you've implemented so many changes now that you've gotten into this stuff. I know what that's like. I came from, it sounds like you and I were very similar, and something with our own health brought us into the research and just maybe the curiosity that we never had before. And then it just became our passion.
I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful, you know, that I even had those struggles because I wouldn't have looked into it otherwise. So
no, it's clearly changed your life.
Yeah.
Before we wrap up, I just want to have you leave our listeners with a few tips on how to know if the light therapy that they're considering is maybe going to give them results. Can you give us a few pointers? And let's talk about it like, you know, even if they did this, it would still be okay. Maybe it's not the best there is, but, you know.
Yeah, when looking for a light therapy device, I recommend checking out, first of all, to make sure that device is using the correct wavelengths. You want something in that mid-600 nanometer range and the mid-800 nanometer range, and most websites are going to say, you know, what wavelengths they're using. If they don't, that would be a red flag to me.
Okay.
You want something that is going to be high enough powered that you can have a short, you know, treatment time and you still get a powerful dosage of light. I recommend first thinking about what size area you want to treat. Because if you get a device that's smaller, it's going to become a real pain to have to move it around. At the same time, if that's all you can do at the time, it's better than nothing. It's great.
Mm-hmm.
So those are kind of some of the things that I recommend thinking about first. And what is cool about Juve is you can decide to get a small device and you don't have to return it. You can add on to that device if you choose, hey, I wish I could treat a bigger area.
Can people try it before?
We do. We have a 60-day money-back guarantee. So we just ask that you keep your packaging if you think you might want to return it because it makes it a lot easier for you in returning.
Yeah.
But you can try it in your home. And 60 days is plenty of time to know whether the light therapy is going to work for you. You might not see your wrinkles totally disappeared by that time, but you're most likely going to feel some benefit to know that my body likes this light. And if you don't, we'll happily take it back. So,
Well, your skin looks great, and I don't know how old you are. If you're comfortable sharing it, I'd love to know, but you...
I'm 38.
38?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you have a 20-year-old, so I was like, whoa! I mean, you look amazing. Do you think it's really helped with your skin appearance on your face?
It has helped a lot, and honestly, I recommend people take, like, weekly, monthly photos of themselves because it's so hard to see the difference, but I'll run into people that I haven't seen for a few years and they'll be like, oh my gosh, your skin looks incredible. And I'm like, really? Like,
all of a sudden,
I don't
look
see it. Yeah, I don't see it just because I see myself every day, but I've been told that. So,
yeah, pictures really help. I mean, I could say pictures have made me a little more self-conscious because I see my smile lines and I never really realized I had them now. I'm at that age. I'm almost your age. I'm 36 and I'm like now doing that mature smile where you don't really smile. You're like,
yeah.
Cause you don't want the lines to show. Anyways, I think I'm going to love using infrared for that too. I'm so excited one day to get mine. And where can our listeners find Juve? Should they follow your accounts? Do you guys have a lot of inspirational stuff there? Tell us how to contact your company.
Yep. You can find us at joovv.com, juve.com. We have a really amazing learn section if you're into digging into the clinical science. It's all linked to clinical studies, but also our articles aren't too hard to understand. If that's not your thing, there's kind of something for everyone. I really recommend checking out our reviews page. We've got hundreds and hundreds of reviews from customers just sharing their experience with the light, so you can read through that. It's always helpful to see what other people are saying. And we have live chat on our website every day, so you can actually get on and talk with a live person about what's going on with you and get recommendations from them for which device might be best. So,
yeah, that would be helpful. All right, Melissa, you've already helped iron out some of the kinks in this topic. In my mind, I'm sure our listeners are feeling a little bit more confident about trying to incorporate red light and photobiomodulation, which is really the term that you're saying the science calls it, right?
Yes, yep.
And even if someone is going to use a sauna, we now understand that they really work together, especially if you're using the sauna first and your Juve after or your red light therapy after. We learned that it's important to treat the whole body. And even if you're using a small device, you want to move it around so that you can treat the whole body. And even something as little as 10 minutes a day can make a big difference. Does that sound right?
Yep.
Awesome. So if you guys have questions, you can always reach out to us. We are Foundation of Wellness Podcast on Instagram and Facebook. And please share this episode with anyone that can use red light therapy and someone that should find out about Juve. So thanks again. And Melissa, I hope you have an awesome week. And I'll talk to you soon.
Yeah, thanks for having me. You as well.
Thanks. Bye.